Hi everyone, welcome to English Vigadan YouTube channel. You are watching English Vigadan YouTube channel to become proficient in English language. So this YouTube channel has grammar, spoken English and language skills related videos. Hope you are getting some benefits and you have been learning spoken English, technical English and other language skills successfully. I wish you all the best. So today you are going to learn about paraphrasing. So what is meant by paraphrasing and how do you manage this paraphrasing? Let's see first, what is paraphrasing? Paraphrasing means formulating someone else's idea in your own words. That means you are reading a passage or you are reading a quotation. Then you have to reproduce or rewrite in your own version. That is what you understood you should produce in your own version. To paraphrase a source, you have to rewrite the passage without changing the meaning of the original text. So in the original text, some content is given with some meaning. So when you paraphrase, you are rewriting that, but without changing the meaning of the original text. That's very important. You can change the structure of the sentence, you can change the wording, but you cannot change the meaning. Thirdly, paraphrasing is an alternative to quoting, where you copy someone's exact words and put them in quotation mark. When you copy someone else's message or someone else's quotation, you quote it as it is said. You use exact words. But in paraphrasing, you don't use exact words or wording. You change them into your own words. So that's the difference paraphrasing do. How to paraphrase? There are many techniques used to make paraphrasing. So here also you have few techniques to use to make paraphrasing the text. First and foremost, you must read the passage several times to fully understand the meaning of the text. So it's not easy, just read and understand. If you want to understand the text or a passage which is given, you have to read several times. Several times means more than one time, okay, many times. Note down the key concepts. That's also very important. Reading and noting down the words or keywords is very, very important for even learning. So academicians, those who are part of academics, these two activities, reading and noting down the keywords, is very, very important. So here, paraphrasing also demands you to write down the keywords. Key concepts means keywords of the passage. Write your version of the text without looking at the original. So when you start paraphrasing, you are writing your own version. One version is given in the original text and you are asked to write your own version. So when you write your own version, that means what you understood from the passage or the text given, you write without looking at the original. So that's very important. Okay. Don't look at the original when you write your own version. Next, compare your paraphrased text with the original passage. Then make some changes to the paraphrase you have written. So comparing your paraphrased text with the original text is very, very important. Then only you will understand there is any change, because change is okay, but change of meaning will not be accepted. So you have to compare and see whether you have changed the meaning of the original text. If you change, then reword it. You can make minor adjustments in it, because your passage should not be too similar to the original text. Paraphrasing example. Here is a passage in green color is the original text and the red color is the paraphrased version. The number of foreign and domestic tourists in the Netherlands rose above 42 million in 2017, an increase of 9% and the sharpest growth rate since 2006. The National Statistics Office CBS reported on Wednesday. Now this is the original text. Okay. Now coming to paraphrased version. According to the National Statistics Office, the Netherlands experienced dramatic growth in tourist numbers in 2017. More than 42 million tourists traveled to or within the Netherlands that year. Representing a 9% increase, the steepest in 12 years. So if you compare both text, the original text, the paraphrased version, they are not too similar. There is change. Even the starting sentence itself is changed. Then according to the National Statistics Office, it is not there. So when you write your own version, you should know who has given this text. So, according to the National Statistics Office is added here. Netherlands experienced dramatic growth. So, there you see Netherlands rose, just rose, one word only used. Okay, rose means go higher, rising high. So, here in your own version, you have used dramatic growth. Why means suddenly there is increase. Okay, 42 million in 2017. So from 2006 to 2017, almost more than 10 years, more than 10 years, there is a sharpest growth. So instead of sharpest growth, here you have used dramatic growth. So some wording, rewording is done. Okay. And some words are added. Then again see domestic increase, the national statistics says, and you will see here travel to or within the Netherlands that year. So number of foreign and domestic tourists. So foreign tourist means they are traveling to other countries, and here domestic means traveling within the country. So that itself is given here, see, within the Netherlands. Instead of using domestic, the writer or one who paraphrased has used within Netherlands. So some kind of use of synonyms or similar words are used to indicate in paraphrased version. So first of all, certain phrases are added and some alternative words are used, like a dramatic growth. Then some synonymous and explanation of the words, like a domestic tourist travel to within Netherlands. So like this, there is a lot of changes happening in the paraphrased version from original text. So some tips, some guidance for you when you do paraphrasing. So start your first sentence at a different point from that of original text, as you have seen in the last paragraph. Okay. So the first line should not be similar to the original text. So completely different according to the statistics, like that. Then use synonyms, words that mean the same thing. See, dramatic growth, steepest growth, steepest rise, something like that, steepest. Change the sentence structure, active to passive voice. So we have seen so many sentences have been changed in the paraphrased version. Break the information into separate sentences. So we can use more sentences or less sentences according to what we understand from original text. So here is another example of paraphrasing. See this, this is about success. So despite the undoubted fact that everyone's version of what constitutes success is different, one should spend one's time establishing and finalizing one's personal vision of it. Otherwise, how can you possibly understand what your final destination might be? or whether or not your decisions are assisting you in moving in the direction of the goals which you have set yourself. The two kinds of statement, mission and vision, can be invaluable to your approach, aiding you as they do in focusing on your primary goal and quickly identifying possibilities that you might wish to exploit and explore. So if you see this original text, too formal. It's telling about success, vision, mission and goals. Okay. Now let's see the paraphrase, how this paraphrase has been worded. We all have different ideas about success. What's important is that you spend time defining your version of success. That way you will understand what you should be working toward. You will also know if your decisions are helping you to move toward your goals. Used as part of your personal approach to goal setting, mission and vision statements are useful for bringing sharp focus to your most important goal and for helping you quickly identify which opportunities you should pursue. Okay, so this is the paraphrased text. So if you compare these two texts, you will see in paraphrased text, there is personal touch, personal opinion. So we all have different ideas about success, which is not there in the original text. There it is given directly to the point, to the factual information. What is success? How we spend time expressing ourselves, vision and mission, etc. Finalizing vision and mission. So here it is too personal. So when you paraphrase, you can use your personal opinion because it is what you understand. See the second sentence itself. What's important is that you spend time defining your version of success. But if you see here, defining, see, one should spend one's time establishing and finalizing one's personal vision of it. So here establishing and finalizing. But here you spend time defining your version of success. So wording is changed and it is more or less personalized. You will understand what should be working towards. So it is as though you are talking to someone. So this way you have to rephrase it to make it simple, because what you understand should be more simple than the original text. How to cite paraphrase. So this is very, very important, because we are taking idea or we are quoting idea or opinion from someone else's text. So we are borrowing. So when we borrow, we have to acknowledge. So that is only citation. So today's research, citation is very, very important. The more citation you provide your paper, the research paper will be standard. So make sure you cite. So cite means you give the details from where you have taken this particular text. After rephrasing it, you have to acknowledge. Like here, example, after the paragraph, towards the end of the paragraph, in bracket, Roos and Kang, 2018, para 11. So this means this text is written by Roos and Kang, which was published in 2018, and para number 11. So we can give para number. If it is a book, you can give a page number. So in this way, you have to cite. So this means citation means acknowledging from where you have borrowed the text. I hope you understood what is paraphrasing and what is the process of paraphrasing and some guidance to paraphrasing. So this is very important activity you do in research field, not only research field, even in classroom also. So this is very important. I hope you have learned better now and you will do better in the future. Thank you for listening. See you in the next video.